Hello guys, Manik here.
And Skiller.
And this is a very special video for you guys. It's a birthday special because it's my birthday. Happy birthday me.
And birthday Manik.
Yeah, so today we're reacting to Chris Brown, who is my favourite English artist. It's the nobody's son outside of music, but because obvious reasons, you can go check that out if you have somehow have not seen that.
But living in a rock in a cave.
Yeah, effectively, but but when it comes to this music, I just can't get enough of it. I just love it. I will just randomly at some point, oh, what's like a Chris Brown song on? It's just, here's my favourite English artist for a reason. It just connects. Every song connects. So I wanted to react to him for my birthday because I thought it'd be quite cool. Quite something different. That's as
a wee,
well.
Wee treat for yourself.
Wee treat.
We said on a wee live stream, got a wee special thing. Hope you would check it out.
Yeah.
If you don't check it out, it's okay.
Yeah.
But it's something Maddie K wanted to do.
Yeah.
So, and it's his birthday. Come on, guys. Let him do it.
Let me do
as
it.
As we're going to do anyway.
Give me some love.
Yeah.
But yeah, so we're going to be reacting to Forever, Don't Judge Me, and Zero. So I went for three songs in like, I guess, different eras. Because I could easily just go on with this album because With You's on the same album.
Great song
yeah, I could have went with Run It, the debut.
Great song,
yeah, but I thought
Lord of War, great song.
Yeah, Lord of War's on this album too, so this album's stacked.
You could do
that. Oh, Kiss too.
Oh, I want that lovey-dovey.
Yeah. Oh, I mean, it's like, well, for me it's
Next to You with GB's, so that's a good song.
Yeah, like that's on the fourth album, I believe.
I haven't, to be honest, I know Chris Brown's like older stuff.
Yeah.
Haven't really listened to any of the new stuff. Possibly heard the song, all these songs, as Maddie K could have played them for me.
I've played them all. I don't know if you're paying attention to Don't Judge Me, but I think you paid attention to Zero. I mean, you're saying you liked it.
We'll find out.
Yeah. But anyway, I did show three different eras. But anyway, guys, make sure you smash that like and subscribe button and any requests down below, English or K-pop, because we're doing the English right here.
Yes, so we'll move straight in Forever.
Yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4. We had to do that.
Everyone's gonna do that. I feel like he's a Tae Yang, so Chris Brown.
He won't let it fall, but he's
falling as well.
Yeah, so into a dark floor, I guess.
Is that him now?
What's that?
Is that what he looks like now?
I believe so, yeah.
Interesting. What I was going to say was, I mentioned it's that he was like one of the first people westernized to do like dance choreos. MJ, forgot Michael Jackson.
And then there was Usher.
Yeah.
And there's quite so many people.
There's a few others, but he's one I can remember.
Yeah.
Especially growing up with him.
Yeah.
And this song, when was this out?
2007.
Okay.
Did that say 2009 though?
Yes, it did.
I'm pretty sure it's 2007.
I'll go with him because he knows a lot.
If I'm wrong, I'm going to be mad at myself.
Yeah. But thoughts, Maddie K, since it's Chris Brown, your favourite?
It's an amazing song. Like, I don't want to say it right now because we just save it for the end. But this
I mean Chris Brown, your favourite.
Oh.
Like, favourite English artist.
Yeah.
I was meaning.
Oh.
I wasn't trying to say this is your favourite because I don't know what is your favourite. Well, actually I do, but I'm trying to downplay it.
Well, since you already said it is my favourite.
Yes.
It is my favourite Chris Brown song, and it just hits every time.
It's like
such a classic.
And Wee Story is last night, no, 2 nights ago I travelled home with my cricket team, and someone requested this song, and I just videoed it straight away and sent it to NDK. I was like, hey, look what the boys requested. So we're like a bit like the, because we're listening to music on the way home. So it just shows you, like, he's got, this song's great.
Yeah, the song's great. It's 13 years on, it's still amazing.
Still going. And you know you've got a hit when you can do that.
Yeah.
Anyway, may as well move into Chris Brown, Don't Judge Me. Which kind of is like a very symbolic title. Don't judge him on what he's done.
Yeah.
Judge him. We're only judging him on the music.
Yeah. Well, I'm a big fan. I would say I know the songs as well. You can do a slow song
too. Yeah, I was trying to figure out, I was like, do I even like this song? And then what I'm feeling is some parts yes and then some parts no. But then I just started listening to the lyrics a bit more and I was like, yeah, please don't judge me because I won't judge you.
Yeah,
because yeah, just let me
because it could be easy to judge someone like Chris Brown or just people in general,
or in like music video, don't judge him and he won't judge what you're going to do. Yeah. Please don't judge me what I'm going to do.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, it was a good song.
Yeah.
In that way.
Yeah.
So different to Forever.
Yeah.
Yeah. And it does symbolise, like I said, don't judge Chris Brown on what he's done. Yeah. Just judge him on that song.
Yeah.
Or on his music. Please don't judge him as a person.
Yeah.
Is what we're kind of done.
Yeah.
We judged him on his music, not what he's done.
Yeah.
Thoughts on it for you?
Oh, it's definitely up there for me. Like, it's one of my top 10.
Yeah.
Because, like, you don't really see a slow song like this from Chris Brown, I would say. Like,
there's, I wouldn't actually know, to be honest.
I mean, that's what I think. You know what I mean? Like, he even has slow songs, but, like, I don't think he's made a music video for them. He's
It's like a B-side track, kind of. And... like it's on an album.
Yeah, like,
is that what you're trying to say?
Yeah, like, I think like he does have slow songs, but yeah, just more like B-sides or album tracks.
His best slow songs with you.
Yeah,
it's a slow song.
Yeah,
I need you, boo. Gotta see you, boo. And the hearts all over the world.
Thanks for the comment.
And the hearts all over the world tonight.
2015.
All right, zero.
Yeah.
You believe I like this song?
I believe, if I remember correctly, I'm pretty sure you said you liked it.
Okay. I thought we were great. You took your love back and ran the same track. I counted all the days. I just hear that. That's about it. Till you were gone. Feeling back, I was caught up. I love the scene to it. Choreo.
Have you been creeping around my Instagram? I was caught.
Sorry. You think I'm thinking about
you? You're a show.
Look at that.
Boss's feet wing. Right here.
That's how many fucks I give.
Yeah.
The homies.
Yeah.
And yep.
I thought he was doing a hucker. I was like,
yeah.
Hey?
If we weren't blocking it, then it'd probably be more hilarious.
I might go back and end it on that. Great song.
Great song, yeah.
Yes, I can understand why I enjoyed it back then, and I enjoy it now.
Yeah.
You know what I would love to see Chris Brown do?
What?
A collab with, like, J-Ho, DK. Yeah. Yeah. Like, some of the best dancers in K-pop.
That's not unheard of. Like, Jason Derulo did it with, like, ETM artists.
He
did it with NCT.
I was going to say NCT did.
Just, well, I think it was Lay from it, so.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, and Chuck Koi in that dance as well. I'd love to see something like
him
pop up, let's say, a K-pop awards show.
Yeah.
And do like a dance,
like
even just a dance battle with like all of them just going nuts, and then all of them going like going off against each other, and then they all just come together right then.
Yeah,
I would just be like, whoa, wow, like come on, his dancing in this one is unreal.
It was,
especially this music,
Sweet, we already know my favorite, so I guess I'm gonna ask what your favorite is.
So since Forever is a really, really good song,
and
yes, it would be up there with my favourites, I'm going to choose this one.
Fair enough.
Yeah, just the chorus was real catchy.
Yeah.
And since I've heard Forever a lot,
and
not this one too much, I just got in the groove pretty quickly. I was like, oh, that's good.
But you can see, even like as you mentioned, where I try to get my dance skills from,
Well, Medicaid, I have seen Medicaid hit the dance floor. At a rugby, rugby club one, just after match functions and all that sometimes, and
once
I can remember it though, and he shocked everybody.
Yeah.
But it kind of got a wee inspiration from Chris Brown there.
Yeah. I mean, like that's probably what he's mainly known for, his incredible dance skills, one of the best.
He is in that movie,
with
that dance. That dance movie where he gets injured at the end. I can't remember what it's called, but I know he's in it. And I was like, yep, Chris Brown, watch him. But I got nothing else to add.
So I hope you enjoyed this special birthday reaction. I hope you enjoy Chris Brown for his music.
Yes, for his music, everybody.
But who's your inspiration? Like, hence why I want to be a main dancer of a K-pop groove, if somehow I'll just make it into K-pop.
Yeah, one thing, since Medicaid is like wee inspiration for kind of dancing is Chris Brown.
Yeah.
Who's your inspiration, guys?
Yeah.
Like, if you, who got you into like dancing or singing or something? Yeah. Who do you aspire to try be like?
Yeah.
So,
sweet.
Saying that, I'm trying to figure out who I aspire to be like.
For a vocal,
I like Harry Styles
a
lot. Yeah. So, probably something like that. Or an Ed Sheeran, Bruno Mars style. Bruno Mars.
Yeah.
He's a good dancer too.
But yeah, thank you guys for watching. Make sure you smash that like and subscribe button. And any requests, you know what to do by now, in the comments.
Yeah.
So, thank you guys for watching, and we'll see you tomorrow for Request Thursday.
Yes.
Anyone.
See you all.